Thank you. like to listen to your suitor's tender serenade. Your suitor's tender serenade.
What? That's no serenade. It's just an ugly noise. I find it most unpleasant. A finisher, I call it. Enough to drive you crazy.
It's a charlatan.
A charlatan.
A charlatan.
A charlatan.
On shouldn't be angry with Captain Silvio, for I've often heard him say that you were the most beautiful woman in the world.
And who said he wasn't charming, too, and a man of taste and discernment? Oh, it's your father who's against this marriage, not me!
What about my cousin Phyllis? She's married to an officer, and is not at all unhappy.
Yes, but that's very different. He's an officer in the militia.
Not at all. He's in the dragoons.
No, my dear. He's a major in the militia.
You're wrong.
I'm not?
Yes, you are.
Well, considering I'm her aunt, I ought to know.
Well, if it comes to that, I am her cousin.
Well, I got rid of him. Ha! Veronique, my dear, will you please get ready?
And anyway, it was Phyllis herself who told me.
Veronique, my dear.
No, she couldn't have told you that.
Well, if he was in the militia, how could he have been sent to Florence? I should like to know.
Be quiet now. You were saying, my dear?
I was going to ask you, Veronique, will you please...
What do you mean, ordered to go to Florence? He was simply traveling for his own pleasure.
Come now, Veronique.
Yes, my dear. You really must control yourself.
Now, as I was saying, will you please...
To begin with, I'm certain that his uniform...
To the devil with his uniform! Will you listen to me?
How dare you interrupt your father?
I'm listening, father.
About time, too. Now then, get ready to receive...
With blue and red faces!
Claret! Ready to receive...
No, it wasn't! It was blue with yellow faces!
Veronique! Receive the new...
In any case, young lady, you ought to be ashamed of trying to argue with your stepmother. Just mind your manners.
To the devil with you both! Now go and leave me in peace!
You hear, young lady?
You too, my dear. You're just as bad as she is.
I tell you, they're red.
Now that's enough!
I tell you, they're yellow!
Cursed females. Talking machines, that's all they are. They'll be at it for the rest of the day. These confounding chatterboxes. I beg you, Veronique, please get ready to receive the new valet whom Dr. Julep recommended to us. Poor devil is waiting out there. Oh, come in, my boy, don't be afraid. The women are away.
Here I am, Your Excellency.
A handsome lad, sure enough. A bit loutish. Doesn't seem too bright, but a good-looking lad. Now then, let's have a look at him.
Don't mind if I do. I know how to walk, you know, though no one ever taught me to.
Look at that now. A fine chassis. Solidly built. And those hands and feet.
Stop spinning me round like that. Makes me all dizzy-like.
All dizzy-like. I adore his cockney speech. But what on earth's the matter with your eye?
Oh, I got that having a scrap with a bloke in the dragoons. I broke 13 of his teeth and smashed 13 of his ribs.
And what was the reason for this engagement?
No reason at all. I just can't stand the sight of a soldier. Makes me mad and I start bashing him in my back.
Bravo.
I must introduce him to Captain Silvio.
And what is your name, my good man?
They call me Pastan.
And are you strong?
Oh, you bet I am. Why, when I hit anyone, he knows all about it, I can tell you.
Oh, yes, by Jove, you're strong. I'd say you're very strong. Even maybe a bit too strong.
I can kill an ox with one blow, and when I hit anyone with this...
Yes, my friend, I quite believe you. Let me have that thing. There's someone I want you to meet, but first, to business. What can you do?
A lot of things, don't worry.
I'm not afraid of climbing stairs, nor am I slow at coming down again. I'm good at cleaning boots and shoes, and I know how to fend for myself. And I know how to cook potatoes in the ashes, no one better. As for logs, I guarantee there's no one who can saw as well as I can. To reassure you now, I must just tell you this. Although I may be stupid, I'm still more honest. I'm more honest than stupid, more honest than stupid. If I were not so very obstinate, I'd have a nicer character. just the opposite. But that's not all the talent I possess. Oh no, I've plenty more, just wait and see. For I can do a lot of things, and quite a lot of other things, too. To reassure you now, I must just tell you this. Although I may be stupid, I'm still honest. I'm more honest than stupid, more honest than stupid.
Trades couldn't do much better, and I don't think I like a jack of all trades. Yet, you're such a haughty fool. I mean, so full-hearted. A good fellow that I cannot but engage you. But most important, will you never accept any bribe?
A bride? Oh, sir, I'm not marrying soon.
I didn't say bride. I said bribe.
A bribe? Is that some sort of pipe?
Marvelous innocence. I mean, Pascal. Would you accept the money a gentleman may offer you to be admitted into my house?
Me? Money? If your excellency can have such like thoughts about an honest fellow like Pascan, then you better leave Pascan alone!
All right, then don't get excited.
No, no, no. Nobody has the right to doubt my honesty. And if a bloke says he doubts it, well, do you doubt?
Of course I do. I mean, I don't!
Oh, but your excellency has doubted! And your excellency has to ask for Pascan's forgiveness for heaven.
Well, forgive me, Pascan. What shall I do with this excessive honesty? But now listen, imagine some military person tries to enter my house.
Military person? Out of the question!
And if he insists? Yes, of course, but if in spite of everything he succeeds at approaching my daughter,
if he approaches, Pascan too approaches fast. If he's here, then I'm here too. If he's outside the house, then I'm not bloody likely to be inside the house. His shadow, says I, and my shadow, so to speak, one same shadow.
Be it so. Well, I'm going to introduce you to the ladies.
Ooh. With yellow faces! With red faces!
Pascan, this is the signora you will be going to obey.
Unless I tell you to otherwise.
And this is my daughter.
How do you do, all? Good morning, miss.
No, no, Pascal, you've cut it all wrong. This is my daughter.
This one's prettiest.
What? He's got good taste.
And now, Pascal, it's time you showed us what you can do. My appetite tells me it's time for breakfast. Laurent, show him how to lay the table.
Yes, father. Come along, Pascal. Give me a hand.
Hell, he really loves to give satisfaction.
Oh, look what you're doing!
Clumsy idiot.
He drops things, but he does it so gracefully.
There you are, man.
Never mind for now, but do be careful another time. Now, what is for breakfast?
He'll make us an omelette. I bought the eggs. They're in the kitchen.
Now's the time to distinguish yourself, Pascal. An omelette. A delicious omelette. Verily, show him the way.
Come along, then. Come with me.
And mind you don't treat my eggs as you did the dishes.
Oh, don't worry, Excellency. I'll take care of your eggs.
I am certainly pleased with my new acquisition from every point of view.
Well, you're easily pleased, then. A nitwit like that, ugly as the devil in only one eye?
Yes, but a good lad. And one that'll keep an eye on you, you scamp.
I don't understand you, Father. You mean you're going to have that one-eyed lackey spy on you?
Yes, precisely that, my pet. And if that Captain Silvio is up to any fresh mischief, he'll have somebody to talk to.
But why, Father, would you want to get rid of a man that I'm irresistibly attracted?
Because I've offered your hand to Mr. Bellino, the chemist. And what's more, you're to marry him tomorrow.
Never! I'd sooner run away with someone tonight!
Extraordinary. One of the rules worked out. She's usually so obedient. Ha! Here comes our breakfast. pretty set, smiling at me and telling me, I am your most enticing breakfast. I am your most enticing breakfast. Waiting for you, waiting for you, waiting for you. I'm waiting for you.
Pesca, borrow me something to
your drink. Look what you're doing.
Oh, sorry, sir. That'll dry soon.
I should hope so. Come, Berenice. Let's take a stroll in the garden. It should help me to digest. This omelet lies a bit heavy on the stomach. Beginning to be sorry I ate it.
Can I come too, Father?
Not likely. And have that Captain Silvio follow you about. No, you'll stay here with Pasquet. He's wonderful at keeping an eye on young girls in love and won't leave you alone for a minute. Do you hear me, Pasquet? I'm entrusting this young girl to your care.
Yes, sir, Excellency, sir.
Come, my dear, let's go.
Oh, that Pasquet. How I hate him.
Thank you.
What do I see?
Kissing me.
Kissing you.
Kissing me.
Kissing you.
I am shocked.
He is shocked.
I am shocked.
He is shocked.
What a shock. What a shock. What were you doing there, faithful servant? Confess now.
I was helping this young lady when she complained of feeling faint.
So, I suspect some treachery. Well now, Pascal, come here and let me have a look at you. Oh, that's a face that I know well. So then your eye is healed. Come a little closer, I beg. Ah, I recognize you now. It's him. I know you run. How dare you show yourself here? Get out at once, or else I warn you now, traitor, you will be sorry you came.
Get out of here, get out at once.
Must you treat me like this? Must you drive me away?
Now what day such a final piece like me now?
Must you treat me like this? Must you drive me away?
If you be such a fool, I'll be sorry you came.
Must you be such a fool?
Always try to keep calm.
Please try to keep calm.
Always try to keep calm.
Please.
Get up at once! 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 Slash a fuss!
Stupid
such a fuss! Get up at once!
Such a strange taste.
A good thing I only had just a mouthful.
Oh, I feel terrible. Well, what are you two doing standing there and looking at me instead of running for help? Get a doctor now!
But my dear, you heard what it said. Science can do nothing for you. It's not a doctor you need, but a lawyer. A lawyer to certify your will. The will in which you leave everything to me.
A doctor! A doctor! Get me a doctor!
Your voice is so low one can hardly hear you.
I've already lost the power of speech. What? The last trump already?
Oh, it's only that charlatan, Mother!
But that's just the man I need. Get him in here now!
But darling, there's an excellent doctor just a few miles away.
Veronique, call the charlatan. Tell him I'll pay whatever is necessary.
Here he comes, Father.
I'll give him my entire fortune if he can get me out of this.
Queen?
My friend, this is the Podestat.
Who commands you to save his life.
Poisonatus?
Now we're done for. He's speaking Latin.
But I know Latin. My late lamented third husband was an apothecary.
Then for God's sake, my dear, translate. What is he saying?
Well then, he said you've been poisoned.
He's really too clever. I know that already.
Poisonatus per personam innocentem in sepso, sed gravem in omeleta.
By a poison harmless in itself, but dangerous to serve in an omelet.
An omelet? That's just it. But is there any way out of this?
Mors imminens.
Imminent death?
Imminent death? My late lamented fourth husband was the counselor of Padua.
But what about his panacea that cures everything?
Remedium constat quinque, centam millia francatus.
That remedy costs 5,000 ducats. I'd rather 5,000 ropes to hang him with.
5,000 ducats?
Assassin! Moribundum est pater familias.
Now what's he suggesting?
Nothing. He's merely asking if you're a father. Yes, Charlatan, he's the father of this young person you see here. I could easily be his daughter myself, but I'm his widow.
Cool Kerima.
He finds love rex who's like it.
Moribundum boerimo.
He said he will cure you.
Si.
If.
Si mihi filiam accordat in matrimonium.
If you promise him your daughter's hand.
But I ask for nothing better. What more could I want than to get my daughter off my hands and recover my health? Unless providing, of course, she doesn't marry a soldier. You're not a soldier. You can have my daughter.
My dear child, you may marry him. I beg you, take him for your husband. Your happiness is not my concern. I know I want to live, I know.
Thank you.
Christian language now, I notice. When you read this prescription, you will be cured by your affectionate son-in-law, Captain Silvio, who never at any time had his eyes on your life. What's this? You're making fun of me! You mean I'm not in poison then?
Lord, so he never was poisoned after all!
I can't promise you
so he never was poisoned after all!
You'll never marry me, Lord!
Stop it, poisoned after all!
I swear for this you will pay dearly!
Stop it, poisoned after all!
You'll never marry me, I swear! Oh no, never!
What should I do?